गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू? आई होप डैट ऑल आर वेल एंड लिविंग सेफ लाइफ एट योर होम। नाउ टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट सम प्रॉब्लम्स फ्रॉम योर बुक पेज नंबर 98। माय डियर स्टूडेंट, ऑल दीज क्वेश्चंस डिपेंड ऑन द डिवीजन ऑफ डेसिमल्स। ओके, डिवीजन ऑफ डेसिमल्स। योर फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज 0.9 डिवाइडेड बाय 10। 0.9 डिवाइडेड बाय 10। एज वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस, व्हेन एनी डेसिमल नंबर डिवाइडेड बाय 10, सो व्हाट विल यू डू? मूव द डेसिमल पॉइंट वन प्लेस टू द लेफ्ट। Move the decimal point one place to the left according to the number of zero in 10. You know very well, in 10 number of zero is 1. In 10 number of zero is 1. So what we will do? Move the decimal point one place to the left. So your answer will be 0.09. Move the decimal point one place to the left. So answer will be 0.09. Okay. Your next question is 1.47 divided by 10. We will apply the same procedure. Move the decimal point one place to the left according to the number of 0 in 10. You know, in 10 number of 0 is 1. In 10 number of 0 is 1. So what we will do? Move the decimal point one place to the left. Move the decimal point one place to the left. So your answer will be 0.147. 0.147 is required answer. Okay. Your next question is 0.5 divided by 100. You know very well, in 100 number of 0 is 2. In 100 number of 0 is 2. So what we will do? Move the decimal point two places to the left. Move the decimal point two places to the left. My dear student, 0.5 we can write here 0.5. 0.5 and 0.5 both are same. There are no changes in these two numbers. Okay. So according to the division rule, in 100 number of 0 is 2. So what we will do? Move the decimal point two places to the left. Move the decimal point two places to the left. So your answer will be, now let us we start to move the decimal point two places to the left. Now look here, this is first place and this is second place. So your answer will be 0.005. Okay, 0.005 is your required answer for this question. Okay, again 1.6 divided by 100. What we will do? In 100 number of 0 is 2. In 100 number of 0 is 2. So what we will do? We will move the decimal point two places to the left. 1.6 we can write here 0.6. 1.6 and 0.1.6 both are same. This number divided by 100. So what we will do? We will move the decimal point two places to the left. Now look here, this is first place and this is second place. So your answer will be 0.016. This is first place, moving of decimal point first place, again moving of decimal point second place. So your answer will be 0.016. 0.016. Okay. My dear student, your next question is 743.5 divided by 1000. You know very well, in 1000 number of 0 is 3. In 1000 number of 0 is 3. So what we will do? Move the decimal point 3 places to the left. Okay. Now look here. This is first place, second place and third place. So my dear student, your answer will be 0.7435 is your required answer. Okay. Again, 250 divided by 1000. We will apply the same procedure. In 1000, number of 0 is 3. In 1000, number of 0 is 3. So what we will do? Move the decimal point 3 places to the left. Move the decimal point 3 places to the left. Now look here. This is 250. 250 we can write here 250.0. 250.0 divided by 1000. Okay. So this is the decimal point. We will move the decimal point 3 places to the left. Now look here. This is first place, second place and third place. So your answer will be 0.250. 0.250 is your required answer for this question. Okay. My dear student, your next question is, divide the following. Divide the following. I hope that all are know about the division procedure. Okay. My dear students, all these questions depend on the division of decimal numbers. Okay. Your first question is 6.36 divided by 6. Now look here. 6.36 divided by 6. I hope that all are know about the multiplication table. 6 1 ja 6, 6 1 ja 6. 6 minus 6, 0. This is 3. Before 3, there is decimal point. So, after 1, we put here 1 decimal point. Again, we can note down the 3. Okay. But 3 is less than 6. 3 is less than 6. So, division is not possible. Division procedure is not possible. In that condition, what we will do? In that condition, we can carry forward the next number. We can note down the next number. After 3, your next number is 6. So this is 6. So it will get to the 36. My dear student, again, I will explain. 6, 1 just 6, 6 minus 6 is 0. We can note down the next number, that is 3. But before 3 there is 1 decimal point. So after 1 we put here 1 decimal point. Okay. And 3 is less than 6. 3 is less than 6. In that condition division is not possible. So what we will do? After decimal point we put here 0. After decimal point we put here 0. Okay. Again we can note down the next number. Your next number is 6. It will give to you 36. Okay. Again, we will apply the multiplication table. 6, 6, ja, 36. 6, 6, ja, 36. Remainder is 0. My dear student, required answer for this question is 1.06. 1.06 is your required answer. Okay. Your next question is 20.85 divided by 5. We will apply here division procedure. 20.85 divided by 5. 5 4s are 20. Okay. This is remainder is 0. Then after we can note down next number. Next number is 8. Before 8 there is one decimal point. Before 8 there is one decimal point. So after 4 we put here decimal point. Okay. Again 5 1s are 5. 8 minus 5 3. 8 minus 5 3. Okay. We can note down the next number. Next number is 5. It will give to you 35. Again 5 7 ja 35. Your remainder is 0. 5 7 ja 35. So remainder is 0. My dear student, required answer for this question is 4.17. Once again I will explain. 20.85 divided by 5. We will apply the multiplication table. 5 4s are 20. Okay, remainder is 0. After 20, there is one decimal point. So after 4, we put here one decimal point. Okay, we can note down next number. Next number is 8. So 5 1s are 5. 5 1s are 5. 8 minus 5, 3. 8 minus 5, 3. We can note down the next number. Next number is 5. So it will give to you 35. Okay. 5, 7, 35. After subtraction, you will get remainder is 0. Okay. So quotient will be 4.17. 4.17 is required answer for this question. Okay. Again, my dear student, your next question is 149.6 divided by 2. What we will do? 149.6 divided by 2. 2 7s are 14. Remainder is 0. We can note down next number. Next number is 9. 2 4s are 8. 9 minus 8, 1. Okay. After 9 there is decimal point. So after 4 we put here decimal point. Okay. After decimal point there is 6. We can note down next number. This is 6. 9 minus 8 is 1 and this is 6. It will give to you 16. 2 8 is a 16. After subtraction you will get remainder is 0. Answer for this question is 74.8 is your required answer. Okay. Again, my dear student, your next question is 116.4 divided by 12. Now look here, 116.4 divided by 12. We will apply the division procedure. For this question, you know about the multiplication table. 12 9 ja 108. 12 9 ja 108. After subtraction, you will get remainder is 8. After subtraction, remainder is 8. Okay. Then after your next number is 4. We can note down next number is 4. Before 4, there is one decimal point. So after 9, we put here decimal point. Okay. 8 and 4, it will give to you 84. 12 7 ja 84. Okay. 12 7 ja 84. After subtraction, remainder is 0. Answer of this question is 9.7. 9.7 is required answer for this question. Okay. My dear student, your next question is E 348.75. 348.75 divided by 15. Now look here, 15 to the 30, after subtraction you will get remainder is 4, 4 minus 0, 4, 3 minus 3, 0. Your next number is 8, it will give to you 48, 15 3 is 45, after subtraction you will get 8 minus 5, 3, 4 minus 4, 0. We can note down next number is 7, but before 7 there is one decimal point, so what we will do, after 3 we put here decimal point, okay. Again we will apply the multiplication table, 15 to the 30, 15 to the 30, 7 minus 0, 7, 3 minus 3, 0, after subtract 7, after 7, you will get one new number is 5, 7 minus 0, 7, and after 7, your next number is 5, we can note down next number is 5, it will give to you 75, you know very well, 15, 5 ja 75, 15, 5 ja 75, after subtraction, remainder is 0, okay, my dear student, your answer will be 23.25 is your required answer for this question, okay. 23.25 is required answer for this question, okay. Your next question is 116.25 divided by 2.5. You know very well, this is dividend and this is divisor. In dividend, after decimal point, number of 0 is 2. But in divisor, after decimal point, number of digit is 1. So what we will do? One digit converted to two digit. So what we will do? After 5, we put here 0. So 2.5, we can write here 2.50, okay. So your question will be 116.25 divided by 2.50, okay. 116.25, this is dividend, 2.50, this is divisor. Now as you are looking in dividend before decimal point, after decimal point there is 2 digit. Now in divisor, after decimal point there is 2 digit. So what we will do? Decimal point cancel by decimal point, okay. So your answer will be, your new number will be 11625. 11625 divided by 250, okay. 11625 divided by 250. So what we will do? 11625 divided by 250, it will give to you, now look here, you know very well, 2 4 is 8 and 2 5 is 10. Which number we will apply here? 250 into 4, it will give to you 1000. 250 into 4, it will give to you 1000. After subtraction you will get 2 minus 0, 2, this is 6, this is 1, okay. And your next number is 5. 250 into 6, it will give to you 1500. After subtraction you will get 125, but division is not possible, so what we will do, we put here one decimal point. Instead of this decimal point, we put here 10, okay. So 250 into 5, it will give to you 1250. After subtraction, remainder is 0. So answer for this question is 46.5 is your required answer for this question, okay. My dear students, all these questions depend on your book from exercise. I hope that it will be very useful to you for your knowledge and upcoming exam. Thank you. God bless you.